Watchman, Watchman PI.
Hello, Watchman. This is the mayor. I have a problem that only you can help me with.
What you got, Mr. Mayor?
What kind of experience do you have with zombies?
Zombies? Zombies.
Why'd it have to be zombies?
Watchman? Watchman!
Yes, Mr. Mayor. Heard everything you asked. I have quite extensive knowledge of zombies, in fact. So what exactly seems to be the problem?
We've noticed a rising trend of unusual activity amongst the population.
What do you mean, unusual?
Well, about a month ago, we started noticing several instances where citizens were caught on surveillance cameras running into walls, running into doors, running off subway platforms. None of the leading scientists have been able to come up with a logical conclusion. So it has to be something supernatural. That's where you come in.
Ah, I see now. Well, it could be several different factors. But let's stick with the obvious, the living dead. Allow me to explain. We have our setting. Let's do a little history lesson. Let's start with the ancient times. In a kingdom known as Kimri, there was a sorcerer, a necromancer, known as Nagash. He was obsessed with making an undead army to take over the world. Kimri was nestled in the desert lands of Nekara. This was the land of the priest kings, who were obsessed with cheating death. The only one to have achieved this was Nagash. Nagash forced a dark elf sorceress to teach him all of her magic. After she outlived her usefulness, Nagash blinded her, cut out her tongue and hands, and buried her alive in his father's pyramid. He wandered around the necropolis of Kimri, summoning undead spirits and demons. Nagash learned a lot of great secrets. Soon after, Nagash slew his brother for the throne of Khemri and started a reign of terror over the lands. During these times, he wrote the 9 books of Nagash in his black pyramid. These tombs were made from human flesh and flourished with human blood. I believe he was instructed along the way by Nyarlathotep, the Black Pharaoh, a messenger of Asaph-Uth, but we'll go into him at a later date. I am not going to bore you with all the details, but there was an uprising that chased Nagash off to the northeast, where he settled in the cursed pit of Nagashazar. Nagash was eventually hunted down and killed by the then king of Khemri, and cut up into little pieces. A race known as the Skaven collected all these pieces and burned them with warp stone, but they missed a piece, the Claw of Nagash.
Okay, now that we have the basis of where the living dead came from, let's do a little science experiment. Or would it be science fiction? Or would this be horror? Ah, whatever. Anyways, we're going to make our own living dead. But in order to do this, I have to find a body.
In order to prove a point, I need to make my own undead. But to do this, I need to find a fresh body and use a couple of incantations from the Necronomicon.
We have our body.
Now that I have a fresh body, I'm now going back to the cemetery. This whole process should take about 10 days. Okay, let's see what we got. I don't see anything.
All right. As we wait for our body to rise from the grave, let me explain a little bit about the living dead. Living dead have a certain problem to themselves. They're always having parts falling off. I don't think so.
Okay, the living dead have a one-track mind, eating, especially brains. The way I understand it, it eases their pain of undeath. Yeah, it isn't the living dead.
It's not the living dead.
How can you be for certain?
The living dead leave behind traces, residue, parts. You haven't seen any dismembered leg, arm, the odd eyeball around your fine city?
Of course not.
Well, there you got it. It's not the living dead, nor leprosy.
What could it be then?
Sounds like zombies to me.
I thought that's what we were talking about. You just said it wasn't a zombie.
I said it wasn't the living dead. Allow me to explain.